Okay. Hello. Hi. Hi, I thought I wasn't going to have mic audio for a second there. But we're good. We are all good. Hello. We are here. We are live. It has been a minute, but we are back and I am so happy to be here. Let's see. Don't want to flip myself. I think I want to flip myself. Do you guys mind if I flip myself about the vertical axis? Is that okay? Let's see. Transform. Flip vertical. Sheesh! Yeah, there we go. Hey. All right, who all do we got here? All plays with the she. I can't hit that pitch. I'm sorry. My voice don't do that. Fastest sheesh in the West. Oh my God, I love that. That's so funny. Let's see. Blaze says just got home. Wahoo. That's right. Well, good timing on my part then. Guy Frogs, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. Is the music a little loud? Don't get me wrong. This is a bop, but I think it's a little loud compared to my audio. We're going to kick it down a few decis. There we go. I think that's a little better. Let's see, Guy Frog says, deliver it. Yes, we aim on delivering today, all right? Today is all about delivery of pizza and of bits and goofs, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, we're delivering today. Mish, oh my gosh, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. You say, hi, Abby. Hello to you, too. I hope you're doing really well. Wait, the Italians are fake? Obviously. Italians are fake. They were made up for the Super Mario movie. We all know this. That's true. Let's see. Only Lily here. Hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. I like your little dog emote. That's so cute. Bubblegum B. Hello. That outfit is adorable. Thank you. I really like it. I really like this one. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's so good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. We love you, Abby. Oh my gosh, you're so sweet. But when you're looking like that, I got a sheesh. Oh my gosh, thank you. You guys are too sweet. JPK, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. Hey, Abby, looking really cute today. Thank you. Thank you. My voice could do that pitch. Oh, brag about it. Brag about it. Look, I don't even try to pretend I don't have like a super deep voice, you know? I was born with the vocal tract length I have, okay? Not much I could do about it. You can't hear the music? Oh, is it too quiet now? My audio mixing is so fucked up. Here, let's bring it up to 26. We'll bring it up a few more decis. Yeah, tell me if that does anything for you. If it's still too quiet, let me know. Let's see. Just watched a Rocket Lab launch from Virginia. Jandra, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's so good to see you. It's funny you mentioned... I swear this music is too loud now. I'm looking at the... It feels like it should be too loud. You still can't hear at all? What? Wait. Guys, hey, can someone else weigh in? Do you guys hear music? There's no music for you? What the fuck? I'm hearing it in my monitor, right? Because I have an audio monitor, and I see it. Bitch, I could see in my OBS. I have the little green bar. What? Let's see. Chrome. Yeah, monitor and output. Okay, do we... What? OBS, you shouldn't have. No, OBS, you literally shouldn't have. Okay. OBS recently had an update, so it might have fucked this up here. I'm gonna do a little aftertouch here. You guys tell me if this does anything. Basically, OBS encodes audio into one of six different audio tracks, and it looks like it's disabled all of my settings for those. How about now? Is this doing anything for you? Yeah. There it is. Okay. Wow. So I've been sitting here this whole time with no music. Now it's probably too loud, right? Now it's definitely probably too loud. Punch down a little bit. Okay. Oh my gosh, this is so cringe. This whole time I've just been without music. Okay, if you guys don't know this about me, by the way, if you don't know this, I cannot stand silence. This is true in real... Hold on, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have stopped myself like mid-thought there, but I just realized, I'm like, you know what? I should probably, since we're not getting into the game just yet, I'm going to set my stream category to just chatting. There we go. Because I'm very chatty today. I have a lot to talk about. Okay, cool. Sorry. Oh my gosh. I have a lot of things to think about. But yeah, if you guys don't know this about me, this is true in my personal life, right? And in social settings and stuff. I can't stand silence, right? Like, I can't fucking stand silence. Like, in my everyday, you know, usually when I come home, I'll play some, like, lo-fi on, like, the Alexa or on, like, the TV or something. Just for, like, background music, or if I'm, like, hanging out with my friends or whatever, like, and we're not, like, playing a video game or whatever, I like to just put music on, right? It just, it makes me feel more comfortable. And I kind of see... Maybe this is weird to say, I kind of see my streams as like a sort of communal hangout space, right? And if I was hanging out with you guys in real life, I would want to play music, and that's why I want to do it here too. So, I'm losing my green screen. Hold on, give me 1 second, let me fix my green screen. Hold on. Where's my duct tape? Found my duct tape. Give me 1 second. All right, I think that should hold. I think that should probably hold, probably. Okay. What was I talking about? Music? I just like playing music. That's the point. Normally if I was hanging out with friends, I would play some more like general. You know, on these streams, I usually play like fucking music from like the Sonic soundtrack or some bullshit, right? If I was hanging out with some friends, I'd play something like more widely appealing. But this is my stream, so I could do, like, whatever the fuck I want, okay? So you get to listen to my music here. This is my house, okay? Anyway, that's the point. Let's see. Oh, that's right. Jandra was talking about a rocket launch. Yeah, so let's talk about that. The Rocket Lab launch from Virginia. That's, like, 10 miles from my house. A little further than that. It's literally, like, it launches off of the peninsula I live on. Right, the launch comes out of Wallops Island, right? That's where Rocket Lab has been launching their rockets from. And yeah, it literally went up like while I was like typing out my go live message, right? So I didn't personally get to see it, but I think Chandler was watching it. So yeah, I didn't check out the launch. Let's see, Cyberwolf JV. Hey, Abby, first time on stream. Well, hello, welcome. Never been able to catch you live because of work. Today is a day off for me, but I'm a little sick, so I wanted to at least say hi. Oh my gosh, Cyberwolf. Hello, welcome to big. This is the big welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. Well, normally I say I hope you're doing really well, but I know that you're doing sick. That's so fucking sad. That's so fucking sad. But yeah, I'm happy you got to catch me live. That's so fun. Well, hopefully I can make your evening a little bit better. I hope I can do that for you for however long you hang out for. Rikandi, oh my gosh, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. Jandra says you're close enough to hear the Rocket Lab rocket launch. Rocket Lab is going to be building and launching their larger rocket from there. Really? I kind of don't follow these projects too closely, but that's very cool. What is their larger rocket? What is it going to be doing? Because maybe I could actually drive out and see that launch. That would be kind of cool. It's funny. I can literally see a Wallops Island launch from my home, right? Like literally I could just go out in the front yard and look up and I can see it, but there's like a cool little viewing location nearby that I could drive out to as well. Let's see. Earlier, Blaze said, drove some friends to the hospital at night and played the Valhalla soundtrack the whole drive. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. I never know what to listen to in the car, right? If I'm driving other people. Because I don't want to put on the radio. Because the radio is just like boomer shit, right? And I fucking hate the radio. But like, I can't put on my normal music because my normal music is cringe as fuck, right? So usually I'll put on like, one that I like doing is Madon's Secret Sky Festival performance from 2021. And the one from 2022 as well. They're both really good performances. I like to play those because they're each like 30 minutes long and that'll get you through most local drives. But like, if I have to drive more than 30 minutes with somebody, I have no fucking clue. I don't have a strategy. So please, if you guys have any music recommendations, you know, let me know. If you have music recommendations, like DM them to me so I can remember them, actually. Oh, hey, it's Recanti, the awesome artist who drew the thumbnail for our podcast. Yeah, okay, so we could talk about that. That was, I would say that was on my agenda. And sometimes when I'm on top of shit, I will actually write down an agenda for the podcast. When I'm on top of things, I write down an agenda for the stream. Today I am not on top of things, so I did not write down an agenda for the stream. But that's one of the things I wanted to talk about, is that Mish and I co-host a podcast called Court Wreckers. And right now our podcast, my podcast command is out of date and it gives the wrong link and the wrong name for the podcast. But the podcast is called Court Wreckers and it is about Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. And you can find the newest episode by clicking this link. So we just released a new episode on, what day is it? Thursday? Tuesday? Yesterday? When did the episode drop? I don't know. It was recently. We just dropped a new episode, and it is covering the second and third parts of the fourth case of the first Ace Attorney game, and that is Turnabout Goodbyes. It is the one where Miles Edgeworth is accused of murder. It's very dramatic. It's a very dramatic case. But yeah, so Recanti is our thumbnail artist for the podcast, and I fucking love it. Holy shit, I fucking love the thumbnail art. Sometimes I feel like the thumbnail art is like what holds me together with that project, I swear. Let's see, Blaze said, I made my own warning label for my car, which says driver may play 80s music for the entire duration of the trip. I love that, oh my gosh. Neutron, a 40 meter tall rocket with a launch mass of 480 kilograms. Okay, cool. So that's the Rocket Lab rocket. Got it. Mish says, you have an agenda? I'm non-binary. I don't have agenda. Oh my gosh. Classic. That's a fucking classic bit. Not to brag, but I have some amount of agenda. I don't know what amount or in which direction, but you know, we got it. Planner, I hardly know her. Lily says Turnabout Goodbyes is one of their favorite cases. It's personally, Mish, we've been doing a tier list for this game, and I think you and I both put Turnabout Goodbyes at our tippy top, right? You and I differ where we put Turnabout Samurai and Turnabout Sisters. But we agree, Turnabout Goodbyes is like the best one. It's a damn good case. Raven, oh my gosh, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's so good to see you. You say, is that a skeleton shirt? It is. It is. See? It's a very cute shirt. I like this one a lot. It's also, this shirt is very comfy. It's actually kind of big on me, so I tuck it all into my waist. But yeah, it's really cute. I like it. This is probably not a scale representation of what my skeleton looks like, I don't think. You know, there's a skeleton inside all of us, right? We all have a skeleton inside of us. And your skeleton is wet right now, so do with that what you may. Nice. Go work, Blaze. I didn't even see the message that got deleted. Out of sight, out of mind. Blaze is the best moderator in the world. I'm into skeleton stuff. More like skeleton stuff is into you. Sorry, I don't make the rules. that the fit is fire. Thank you. Thank you. You know, actually, that's a pretty good lead into the next thing I wanted to talk about on my agenda, right? I am on like a razor's edge here if I could remember all of the things that I wanted to talk about today. Sorry, it's been 2 weeks. I didn't stream last week. I took a little break, had some stuff to take care of. It's been 2 weeks. I feel like I'm rusty, you know? I just have so much stuff I want to talk about. But one of the things I wanted to mention was that I got a new foundation. Hello. Hello. I got a new foundation, okay? Literally, I got the same foundation I always do, which is Physician's Formula. You better believe it. It's very good. But I got it one skin tone darker. Because previously I had literally the lightest skin tone they sell, because if you can't tell, I'm white as fuck. But I decided to just go ahead and get one skin tone darker, and I think I like it. It's probably not at all fucking noticeable through the stream. Or maybe it is, I don't know. But it makes me feel a lot more confident. It makes me feel a lot better, because I think it matches a lot better. I think it matches a lot nicer. So yeah, I'm just really excited. I was kind of nervous, right? Because this is the first time I put it on was when I was getting ready for stream, and I was like, wow, I really hope this doesn't look awful. Because if it does, I have no backup plan, you know what I mean? Like... but yeah, so I want to talk about that too. Just, you know, since we're talking about the fit, since we're talking about the skeletons, you know, I just wanted to talk about that. I once had a badass gothic angel of death sweater when I was in my late teens. I miss it so much. Don't take this the wrong way, because I mean this in the most positive way. That sounds like the most late teens thing I've ever heard. That sounds so incredibly late teens, and I love you for that. I love that. Being that close to Wallops, you've likely seen a few Antares CRS launches. Really? I've only like just within the past few months even like realized that I live so close to a rocket launch site, which makes sense. Because NASA Langley is literally, like, down the street from me, right? So it makes sense that there's a launch site, you know, in the area. But, literally, I haven't been tracking the area for launches. Like, I could have been watching rocket launches this whole time. Like, it's messed up. Let's see. Blaze says, related to my new foundation. Oh, so that's why you're glowing. You know what? I have been feeling a lot, like, nicer lately. I've been drinking more water, and I've been getting more sleep, so... I don't know. I've been having good vibes lately, and I hope you guys have been, too. Taking notes. Abby is white as fuck. Yes, and don't forget it. And don't forget it. I used to tan, but now I lean into my Irish paleness, and I own it. I tan an okay amount, right? But I don't go outside. During the summertime and shit, like when the sun is out, I get the classic farmer's tan, right? Cause I wear clothes most of the time I wear clothes. So I end up with like heavy tan lines, cause I go outside to like go running and stuff. And I like going outside. Like I like going on hikes and being in nature and stuff. I like being outside. But I don't go out with the purpose of tanning. So I get these nasty tan lines like every summer. It's so annoying. I have like the same foundation. Yo, don't fuck with Physician's Formula. One of these days I want to go to Ulta or Sephora to get color matched for my foundation. And yes, I want them to suggest a way too expensive foundation for me. Okay. And I'm going to get a sampler of it for sure. But the nearest Ulta or Sephora, there's like an Ulta to the north and a Sephora to the south, and they're both like a 30-minute drive away, and I can't be asked to go out there. But so far, I really like Physician's Formula. You better believe it. It's very good. Very comfortable. You look really cute, but maybe your leather jacket would be more goth with the skeleton t-shirt. I thought about that, but honestly, I think I would just be way too fucking warm. I think I would be way too fucking warm in that. Taking notes, Mish is also white. Yeah. and small. Misha's so fucking small. Misha's so small. It's ridiculous. CRS equals commercial resupply service for the ISS. You know what? Okay, actually, Jandra, you guys are doing such a good job. You're reminding me of another thing on my agenda that I wanted to talk about, that I'm excited about. Okay, I wanted to talk about, so we have a running joke on this stream. It's not really a joke. It is true, okay? It's just a true statement that I can't read, okay? I don't know how to. Right? This is a true thing. I've talked about before how the last time I finished a book for recreational purposes was in 2013. You know, I'm not proud of that, right? But I am here. I am proud to say, and I don't think I talked about this on like Discord or anything either. I finished a book. I finished an audiobook. So it doesn't really count. I finished an audiobook. But I finished listening to The Martian. That's why Jandra reminded me, because The Martian is about space, right? And it was really nice. I got into this rhythm, right, where basically I couldn't listen to The Martian while I was doing chores or like grocery shopping, or like if I was doing other shit, I couldn't listen to The Martian because I was so interested in it. I thought it was so good that if I got distracted, I would like get annoyed, right? It's not like a podcast, or if you miss like whatever 15 minutes, it doesn't fucking matter because it's a podcast. No, books are written and edited with a purpose. You have to listen to all of it for it to make sense. So what I started doing was I only listened to it when I went out running, because I'm not super distracted when I'm out running. You know, there's not too much to pay attention to, aside from like your pace and your heart rate and stuff. And it became this really nice routine where it was just like every evening, you know, me and Mark Watney, right? We would hang out for our evening run together and, you know, we would just chill out and he would end up in disastrous situations. And it was really great. I guess the reason I want to talk about this, the reason I want to bring this up is because my revelation is that, books are really good. I'm 29 years old, and I'm just now learning that books can be really good, you know? Let's see here. Candy says, hands me a book. I ain't reading all that. Happy for you, though. Or sorry that happened. I mean, like, that's kind of been my attitude, right? Books are so fucking long. Books are so long, Ricanti. That's the thing. Let's go, book pilled for the win. Oh my god. Yeah, no, like literally book pilled. That's guys, I've been book pilled. You're not even wrong. Yeah, libraries are good too. Yes, we have a local library that's like kind of lame. Like it's kind of a pretty underwhelming library, but it's a library, okay? And libraries are based and great and fantastic. My hot take on books, they're pretty cool. That is a hot take. Let's see, Jandra says, I have never read fiction novels. My autistic mind just cannot see more than just the words on the page. But if it's educational or technical stuff, I read that all the time. You know, it's weird. It's weird, right? Because, like, educational stuff is so boring. It's so boring. I'm sorry. Okay. I have fucking, you know, I have books for school and stuff. I have books and shit about nuclear engineering, and they're fucking boring. They're so boring. But The Martian is like fiction, but it also taught me about Mars. Okay. So it's like educational, but it's also cool, right? So I really liked that. And that's the thing, the problem I have with fiction, right, is I feel like I'm wasting my time if I read fiction, which is that's a dumb way of thinking, because obviously I'm not wasting my time. But I like The Martian because it's a little bit of both. It's a cool fiction story, and it's also like, and it's also, it also teaches me stuff, right? Let's see. Mish says, congrats on finishing a book. Thank you. Rikanti says, oh, neat. I like the movie. Chandler and I watched the movie, too. It's very good, and it made me cry because space is beautiful, and I frequently cry over the glory and beauty of space. It does not take much. Raven says, you changed, Abby. I thought I knew you. Who reads a book? Oh, you listen to someone reading the book to you? That's fine. Right? Yeah. Okay. Books are too long. That's why I play Ace Attorney games. No, like, that's also part of it. Like, I can handle a visual novel because, like, visual novels have music and moving pictures and colorful characters, right? Like, I feel like there's, I feel like they're, like, also visual novels usually have a window, right? You can only read, like, two or three lines of text at a time, depending on the visual novel. I think that also makes it easier for me, right? Because you look at a page and you're like, oh, that's so much. That's so much. I'm not reading all that. But a visual novel, it's like, nah, bud, you only got to read, like, two lines at a time. Just do that 1,000 times and you've read, you know, you've read the equivalent of, like, a long book. You should read horny visual novels like me. Rikanti suggest. All right, Rikanti. Hey, Rikanti, there's nobody else in chat right now, right? It's just you and me, right? Like, all the other messages in chat, they're like robots. They're not real people. Can you, like, hypothetically, could you suggest a horny visual novel? Hypothetically, could you maybe hypothetically, right? Suggest a horny, like, a super, super ribald and horny visual novel to me, please. All I read is Japanese light novels. No, that's valid, though. Bagel Basil. Oh, I love that name. I love the name Bagel Basil. That's so sweet. Hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. Thank you so much for following. As you no doubt know, every follower gets a glow stick. Let's see what glow stick you get. Jondra says, technical books are like that, more images and, my scroll thing's fucking up, more images and diagrams than words. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's cool. I do like a good diagram, but also, like, technical books I get confused by, which is not great for my profession, but it does happen. I have to look at enough technical shit for my job. Like, I don't really have that much of a desire to do it on my free time either. But, you know, I bet you if I found the right, like, tech manual, I could probably get pretty deep into it. Let's see. Luna, have I said hello to you? Luna, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. Luna says, I'm on a bit of a dry spell, but I did get the one on the witch who hunted slimes for 300 years and got to max level. Huh. I guess, is that a visual novel? That sounds kind of fun. I don't mind that. All right, Bagel Basil, thank you again for following. Here is your glow stick. Welcome to House Yellow. I love that for you. Scientist, splitting the atom creates a nuclear bomb blast. Me. Oh, no. Blaze with the scissor and paper emoji. Scientists crying. Deadass, when I was a kid, I was... And this is what's fucked up about, like, my brain. I'm about to tell a story, and I don't know if this is real or if I've internalized this memory from a social media post, but I swear to God, when I was a kid, I was so afraid that I would accidentally split an atom and cause a nuclear explosion, right? Because, like, atoms are everywhere. Everything is an atom, right? Like, what's stopping me? What's stopping me from, like, accidentally splitting one? You know what I mean? Let's see. Bagel Basil says, yellow! Yeah, yes! Welcome to House Yellow. I love that. But yeah, I can't retain information at all except by direct experience and often very... And I'm often poor at getting that. I'm honestly rather worried about that. It's so... That is something I think about a lot, right? Is it's like, how do I put this? Let me see if I can put this specific existential feeling into words, right? So Luna is talking about, she says that she can't retain information at all except by direct experience, and I'm often very poor at getting that. I'm worried about that. So there's only so much time in a day, right? And we only have so much time in a human life, right? And I worry that I am not learning as much or experiencing as much as I can with my human life, right? And it's like, you could do the same thing over and over and keep experiencing new things within that experience. I go to work every day, and it's always a little different, but there's like diminishing returns, right? After you do a certain thing so many times, each additional experience you get less out of, I feel like. And I feel like I'm at a point in my life where so many of the things I do are at that like 90th percentile of like, you're not getting much out of this anymore, right? And I don't know what to do about that, you know? So, I don't know. I thought maybe I could put that feeling into words, but I don't think I quite got there. I heard the chance of accidentally splitting an atom when cutting paper is infinitesimally small, but not zero. Blaze, I would actually, I know you're making a joke, but I would put doubt on that, right? Because to split an atom, you have to actually overcome the binding energy of the nucleus. And that binding energy is really strong. And the energy required to just push the atom to the side is not very strong. So I actually think the chance is literally zero. I don't think it is possible. I think if you were just using scissors, you would just push all the... Anyway. Abby's stronger than that strong nuclear force. I think categorically, I don't think I am, right? Because any force I would exert on something would be the electromagnetic force, right? Or the weak nuclear, fuck, I don't know, whatever. Anyway, I watch YouTube vids up to 2x speed in order to consume more info. So actually, okay, yeah, Jandra, along this line of thinking, I used to be like that a lot, right? Where I would listen to podcasts at 2x speed to get more information, to get the most out of my time, to get the most out of my attention. But what I kind of found was happening, and maybe this is because I'm old, right? Because I'm old as shit, I'm turning into bones and dust. I started just getting exhausted, right? Listening to podcasts wasn't fun for me, right? I didn't feel like I was getting anything out of it. Like, there was a point in my life where I was just mainlining NPR, right? I was just mainlining like NPR, Radiolab, 99% Invisible, like anything that felt educational to me, I was just going super hard into it. And I felt like, one, I wasn't actually retaining any of the information. Two, I wasn't enjoying myself at a certain point. Radiolab fucking rules, so hard to not enjoy yourself. And three, I was feeling exhausted. I don't know, it turned all of my idle time into stress at a certain point. And I don't think that's good for you, you know? But yeah, I listen to court records at 0.5 speed, best 6 hours of my day. Every day I wake up and I listen to court records at 0.5 speed. I don't do anything else while I listen to it. I sit silently in a dark room, tranquil with my eyes closed. Yeah, exactly. That's why I've been trying to write about stuff I read/watch/play after I finish or as I go. It helps keep everything straight in my brain. Also using tracker things like Letterboxd or Analyst. Yes, so actually I was recently listening to an episode of the podcast Reading Glasses, and they were talking about retention in reading, right? But I assume this applies for video games and movies and TV shows as well. They said one of the best ways to retain what you read is to write about what you read after you're done reading it. So I have an account on Goodreads, right? And when I was done with The Martian, I stream of consciousness wrote out like 3 paragraphs about what I was feeling and thinking after I finished the book. And I recently made an account on a TV tracking app. I think it's called like Tracker or something. T-R-A-C-K-R, or it's just called TV Show Tracker. It has a really uncreative name. I forget what it's called. But I've been using this TV show tracking app where I've been tracking all the movies and TV shows I watch, which it's not a lot. I don't watch that much TV or movies. But whenever I finish a TV series or whenever I finish a movie, I write a little personal note about it. I don't like leave a review or a comment or whatever. It's just for me. I just write out a paragraph. So if I'm ever like, oh, how did I feel about, Puss in Boots: The Last Wish, right? I can go, which by the way is a fantastic movie. I can go to my notes and I could read how I felt about it. And then I feel like that activates some neurons, that triggers some synapses, that helps me remember stuff. Let's see, Blaze says, I've played Omori for 10 hours now and only just passed the prologue. Oh my gosh. I click on and read everything in games. I am like that as well. It took me forever to finish Persona 5. It took me 100 hours to finish Omori. Oh my gosh. Yeah, Blaze, you've been sort of not cataloging, but you've been talking about your playthrough of Omori on the Discord. And I've seen that. I just have nothing to add to it because I'm not familiar with the game. But yeah, I know you've been playing it. I'm happy you like it though. It seems like an interesting game. Luna says, I apologize for that poor sentence. What are you saying? Oh, let's see. Okay. Luna says, Abby, have you been exposed to nuclear radiation? Because you're absolutely glowing. I mean, we have all been exposed to nuclear radiation, right? We have all been exposed to ionizing radiation. It comes from space. Cosmogenic radiation is a large source of radiation in our lives. And it comes from the ground. Natural radiation is another prevalent source. Depending on where you live, the building materials of your house may be somewhat radioactive. Obviously, as we all know, smoke detectors have radiation sources in them. That's how they work. Bananas have naturally occurring potassium, which has radiation in it. We're all exposed to radiation. I have been exposed to a measurable amount of radiation through my professional work. It is not a lot, but they've measured exactly how little it is because I wear a dosimeter. The amount I get from my work is probably less than Chandler got working as an archaeologist. Since she worked in the sun, I bet her radiation dosage was way higher than mine. Because literally just being out in the sun, you know, will give you more dose. Working as an airline pilot or a flight attendant gives you a lot of dose too, because you're higher up in the sky. Let's see, OC Da Femboy is now following me. Hello, welcome to the chat, welcome to the channel. I hope you're doing really well, OC. As you know, every follower gets a glow stick, and it just so happens that your glow stick is orange. It's orange. I love that for you. Welcome to House Orange. Thank you again for following. I hope you appreciate your glow stick. Fascinating. Serious. Yeah. So I guess not to answer your question, because it wasn't a real question. But yes, I have been exposed to radiation, and so have you. The live action or cartoon version of Puss in Boots. There's a live action version of Puss in Boots. No, I was talking about the animated one that just came out. Puss in Boots: The Last Wish, the sixth movie in the Shrek series. It's really fucking good. Like, hey, not to fucking buzz market for DreamWorks, but Puss in Boots: The Last Wish is like a really fucking good movie. It's really good, and I recommend it if you haven't seen it. There's a paleontologist that streams paleontologizing. Ooh, I kind of like that. That's a fun name. Yeah, that movie is way better than it needs to be. Right? Shilling. Okay. All right. You know what? Hold on. Blaze, let me anti-shill. Since I don't think Puss in Boots and The Last Wish is on streaming right now, I encourage all of you to go out and pirate it immediately, right? So that's me anti-shilling for DreamWorks. Go pirate 1337.to. Go pirate Puss in Boots and The Last Wish. I am not joking. tell them I sent you. When you get a cease and desist, tell them I sent you specifically. Okay, already done. There we go. That's one. Based. You'll love to see it. Blaze says I saw it in theaters. Oh my gosh, that seems like it would be a fun movie to see in theaters. Actually, it's a really sweet movie. You guys, it's really sweet. Christopher Walken was the live action one as Puss. No way. When did the live action Puss in Boots come out? All right, where are we at? Oh my gosh, we're at like 45 minutes. Sorry, I've missed you guys. I like talking. Yeah. Oh, you know what? I brought drinks with me this time. Hold on. I brought water. I brought water and I brought coffee. The coffee has a little willow on it. It was 1998 for the live action Puss in Boots. Oh, okay. Got it. So it's like old. Holy shit, I hope my drinking sounds didn't come through the mic. I have like a sore throat, actually. Excuse me, holy shit. I have like a sore throat, and I don't know why. I have a theory, though. And maybe some of you guys are all smarter than me, so maybe you could help me crack this one. Last night, I cooked frijoles fresca bowls, right? And the recipe called for garlic powder, right? Which is like, okay, yeah, garlic powder, obviously. Every household should have garlic powder because it rules, right? But it turns out halfway through the recipe, I used up all our garlic powder. So I was like, huh. I'm looking through the cabinet and I'm like, what can I use in place of our garlic powder? Like, what else would work? And we have garlic salt. So I substitute the garlic powder for garlic salt pretty much one-to-one, right? Like, I think it needed, like, a few tablespoons of garlic powder or whatever, so I just used garlic salt instead. And, when I was eating it, it was good, but it was really over-seasoned. Does garlic salt, like, dry you out or something? Like, I have a sore throat even today. Did I OD on garlic salt? Hey, write in. Let me know. Let me know if that's like a problem. let's see. Blaze says, been missing when you played video games, unironically. Oh shit, yeah. When was the last time because last time we created a D&D character. When was the last time we played a video game on this channel? Actually for real. Sorry, a bit of an echo there. Okay. It was 19 days ago in our Kerbal Space program. Okay. Okay, you know what? Yeah, let's play a video game. I have a kind of goofy concept for today's stream, and I'm not sure how well it'll work, which is maybe a good sign. Rickandy says, I'm a hypochondriac, so anytime I have a sore throat, I immediately assume I'm dying. So I'm kind of the opposite, right? Whatever the opposite of a hypochondriac is, I guess hyperchondriac, is that anything? Could I be a hyperchondriac? If I'm ever sick, I assume I'm not. My baseline assumption is that I don't get sick, that I'm too strong to get sick. I try to use willpower to get rid of my sickness. Mish says, I love all kinds of salt, especially garlic salt. Bitch, I know you like salt. I know you're, yeah, the salt emojis, yeah. Yeah, I know you're like the queen of salt, okay? Oh shit, I'm like falling off my yoga ball here. All salt dries you out. Salt is used for preserving meat when not in the freezer. Shit. You guys, my meat is preserved now. I ate too much garlic salt and now my meat is preserved. You hate it. You hate to see it. Garlic salt sounds like a double whammy against a vampire, right? Yo, actually, how to beat a vampire? Use garlic salt. Absolutely. Speaking of salt, a new type of battery coming out is a solid-state sodium battery. Ooh, I believe. Hey, let me play one round of a competitive online game, and I'll get you enough salt for all the batteries. No, that's really cool. I don't know the details of it, but I know lithium batteries are problematic because lithium mining is difficult and destructive, but sodium is highly abundant. I'm sure these batteries are not just straight up rock salt, though. I'm sure they're a little more complicated than that. The opposite of a hypochondriac, a well-adjusted person. I would never self-describe as well-adjusted, but okay. if I'm ever sick, I assume I'm not. Every dad ever. I'm one of these days I'm gonna beef it. I'm gonna fall off my yoga ball and I'm gonna beef it. Abby mummifying herself live on stream. Oh, that'll be fun. That'll be fun. When are we gonna do, you know what, how about in April? In April, I'll do a live embalming stream, right? I'll just embalm myself live. All right, let's play a video game. Do I even have my Steam open? Motherfucker, do I even have my Steam open? No, obviously not. I did install the game though. All right, so here's the deal. Let's talk about this. We're gonna be playing Pizza Tower. We're gonna be playing Pizza Tower and Wario Land 4, right? Why these games? Let me explain. Chandler showed me a trailer for Pizza Tower like a month ago, right? And the music in the trailer was so fucking good. I have been listening to the soundtrack for this game basically nonstop since then for the past month. This game, and the game has started to build up a mythology in my brain around the soundtrack alone, right? Like, how do I put this? In my head, I have started to build an image of what I think this game is, based only on its soundtrack. And I have a lot of thoughts and expectations as a result. I have not played the video game yet. All I know about this game is that it is a sort of spiritual successor to Wario Land 4, which is such an insane pull for a indie game to make, right? If you guys are familiar with Wario Land 4, it is a Wario game that was on the Game Boy Advance that was known for being really fucking weird. It was a very weird entry into the Mario series of games. Basically, it followed Wario trying to plunder, like, a pyramid or whatever to get, like, you know, a lot of money or whatever. It's Wario. You know his deal. But the game had, like, a really weird sound design, like, aesthetic to it. You'll see. But, I've basically been, like, low-key kind of obsessed with this game since I started listening to the soundtrack. So I thought what would be fun today is if we switch, we play like 10 minutes of Pizza Tower, then 10 minutes of Wario Land, then 10 minutes of Pizza Tower, then 10 minutes of, and we switch back and forth. I don't know if this is a dumb idea, but I want to try it. So that's the idea. That's what, sorry, I hear voices. Oh, that's probably people outside. Right, like people in real life, in the real world. Sorry, my window is open right now. So I heard voices. Also, did my game just crash? What the fuck? Just closed out. Anyway. Sorry, I'm opening up both Wario Land and Pizza Tower right now. But yeah, so... So basically, that's where I'm at. This game has this sort of like weird mythology in my head, and that's kind of where I'm at. So I'm very excited. I'm very interested in playing this game. You'll see it has a really like weird art style, and it has like a pretty cool soundtrack. Oh, let me get my Xbox controller. Obviously, let me get my Xbox controller for sure. My trusty dusty controller. I don't know where to put like my keyboard because I'm still gonna need mouse control. Oh, you know what? Hold on, I need. This is so scuffed. I tried to set this up to be real smooth too, and then I kind of forgot to follow through with it. But it is, okay, what I'm doing now, I mapped a hotkey to my Xbox controller so that I could push a button to switch between my scenes, but I forgot to actually run the program that does the hotkeys. There we go. Cool. All right, sick.
That's the wrong one. That's the right one. Ooh. You're a little loud. Sorry, you're a little loud. All right, cool. All right, it looks like we're there. And you know what? I'm going to flip myself again. If you don't mind, I'm going to sort of flip myself around the axis. There we go. All right, cool. All right, I think we're good to go. Oh, yeah. Let me set my timer. So we got our little text at the bottom that's going to tell us how much time before we start. So, yeah, I'll give us 10 minutes. I think that's a good sort of place to start. All right, cool. All right, we're doing it. We're playing a video game. We're actually, for once in our life, playing a fucking video game. Oh, yeah, so, there's a little intro cinematic to this game that I guess I should mention. It wasn't super long. The animation is wild, by the way. In the intro cinematic, our player character here... His name, by the way, from what I understand, is Peppino. He has a pizza shop. And you see that he is in enormous crushing debt for his pizza shop. And he's kind of trying to cope with, like, how he's going to deal with that. And then while he's doing that, basically, I guess this guy, this, like, pizza-faced motherfucker... is like, hey, I have a big tower that's, like, right next door, and I'm gonna fucking blast your entire pizza shop with a giant laser. And Peppino's like, please don't. And then he runs over to the tower, and that's how the game starts. Oh, cool, so I could, like, climb up walls, too. Hey, guys, I remember, like, nothing about Wario Land, by the way, so that knowledge is not gonna help me. Let's just go ahead and get into the first level, I guess. Okay, great. All right, press A to jump, hold down in a direction to crawl. Okay, cool. Gross. Okay, I really don't like the sound effect. All right, cool. Okay. Easy, I'm a good enough gamer to deal with this. You can break marble and metal with blocks underneath you with a body slam. Okay. Press down while in the air. Got it. By the way, let me know how the sound mixing is. If the music is too loud or if the music is too quiet, please let me know. Start the body slam from higher to destroy metal blocks. Okay. Great. That makes sense. Some blocks may be hidden. Keep an eye out for them. Press X to destroy them. Okay. Hi! Oh, you're cute. You're like a little mushroom. You're like a little mushroom guy. I love that. Press X to do the grab dash. It can destroy marble blocks. Okay. Cool. Hold RT to start a mock run. If you hold RT, then jump on a wall, you will start wall running. Okay, great. Makes sense. Press A while wall running to jump off a wall. Keep RT held to stick on other walls. A tip, you can also use the grab dash to start a wall run while in the air. Just keep RT held. Okay. Hot damn, dem legs. Oh my gosh, Christina, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's so good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. Hi, yes, thank you. Thank you. I have them. I have legs. Nobody can say otherwise. Intro look reminds me of Pajama Sam. Okay. Especially with, like, the big tower, I totally see that. Is that the pizza time theme in the back? Okay, okay, Lily, hold on. Okay, stop the clock. Everybody stop the fucking clock. I need to, okay. I was gonna talk about this, but I had no graceful way of doing it. Yes, to answer your question. Guys, I need you to listen really carefully. Listen really carefully to the music for this level, okay? I'll wait till the melody loops back again, but please, just listen. This little tune right here. Right? Okay, you get it. Yeah, just the dun 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 da 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 da. Right? Alright, let me see if I can find this. Yeah. This video fucking destroys me, you guys. Okay, yeah, this is it. One more, please, real quick. Bro, like, bro. Pizza, pasta, put it in a box. I'm gonna put some dirt in your eye. Wait, what the fuck? Why? I was thinking the Spider-Man song. Oh shit. Wait, I think I might know the one you're talking about too. Spider-Man pizza time music. I think this one's actually different. Are you talking about this one? I mean, this song's fucking funny too. Is, oh god, okay, I gotta turn that down a little bit. This song is what a fucking, this is what my brain sounds like at around 1 p.m. every day, I swear to god. Oh wait, shit, it does do that melody. Wait, yeah, give it a few seconds. Let it cook. Bro, wait, it does it in the, what does this mean? Fuck, what is that tune? Ba 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 da 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 da. What is that tune? What is that melody? So is it from Spider-Man or is it from Pizza Pasta Put It in a Box? What is it from? Holy shit. Yeah, okay, so this song does it as well. Holy shit, that's where this song comes from? It's gotta be, sorry, I didn't mean to bump the mic. It's gotta be some sort of like Italian cultural thing. I have to assume Spider-Man 2 for the PlayStation didn't invent this tune, and I have to imagine Pizza Pasta Put It in a Box, deliver it to my house and put it on my cock, my cock, my cock, my cock, my cock, my cock, my cock. I have to assume that song also didn't invent the tune, right? I have to assume that it's just like a cultural thing. I have to assume it's a cultural thing that I am massively clowning on right now, which is maybe insensitive. I thought it was from Spider-Man. I mean, is there, like, what could I even Google? What would I even be able to Google to determine this? Like, I don't... The first thing that popped in my head was Googling traditional Italian pizza music, but I think that might be I think that actually might be racist. I don't think I could Google that. So you know what? Let's just go back to the game, please. Also, I yeeted my controller off my lap while I was listening to that song. Yeah, I was so thrown off by hearing that song. It even knocked my battery plate off. Oh shit. Blaze has got the forgive my expression, but Blaze has got the sauce for us. Here, I'll put some music on. Alright. Mish is Italian and gives you permission to search for that. Oh, thank you, Mish. Thank you. But it looks like Blaze has already done the fucking legwork for us. Believe me though, I'm not shy about doing legwork, if you know what I'm saying. I do a lot of squats. The specific version, though, I've heard this in YouTube videos all the time, but I never realized it came from Spider-Man 2. Yeah. So, Mish, this specific one I was playing a moment ago, yeah, that one comes from Spider-Man 2. The specific, like, meme version, yeah. That's actually, I used this song in the little preview video I did of the latest episode of Court Wreckers. I used this in the Ratatouille bit. Which I get it, Ratatouille is French, not Italian, I don't care. Alright, let's see. Okay, here we go, see? Great minds want to know. What exactly is the Spider-Man 2 pizza theme song? It appears to be from Spider-Man 2 video game, and a YouTube video of it has over 650,000 views. The music seems to be similar to a VeggieTales song. Oh, how deep does this go?
He had a hat,
my high silk hat.
He wore it high upon his head so proudly, a beautiful hat,
my high silk hat.
A hat like this just makes him feel so grandly. Now fancy this and fancy that. The splendor of the
so this is the VeggieTales version, I guess.
In a royal cap. I feel so.
This is a good animation though. All right, we get it, right? So it's in now. It's in VeggieTales. It's in hello, Stream Deck, whatever. Okay, I was trying to be cool. Stream Deck, whatever. So okay, it's in Spider-Man 2. It's in VeggieTales. It's in Pizza Tower. It's in Pizza Pasta. Put it in a box. Deliver it to my house and put it on my cock. It's on that song. Where does this song come from? There's a couple edited versions of it too. 1 hour version, MIDI, bass boost with 100,000 views. There's also edits where it's overlaid as the audio for a Star Wars duel, Italian army training video. A guy straight up plays the entire thing on an accordion. It seems to be a meme, but there's only videos on the topic. Okay, no KYM either. What exactly is this? Where did it originate? Okay. The pizza theme comes from a brutally difficult delivery minigame in Spider-Man 2. We had to deliver. Wait. Okay, here we go. The theme is based off of Funicula. Its popularity seems to stem from the insane difficulty of the minigame. So that's the actual answer. It seems like it comes from a traditional Italian song called Funiculi Funicula. Let's see if we can find it. Yeah, okay, here we go. There we go. It has 15 million views. And I bet you the top comment is about Spider-Man 2. My eyes, Italian music. Or my ears, Italian music. My eyes, Italian flag. My brain, pizza time. Call me crazy, but this song would be great for a mission where you have to deliver pizza. Yes! We did it! Yeah, call me crazy, but this song would be great for a mission where you have to deliver pizza in a video game. Hey, that's pretty cool. Hey, Blaze, you playing that sound effect and me, like, waving my arms, right? That made me reach my step goal on my Fitbit. That kicked me over to 8K. I beat my step goal because of that. All right, cool. I don't think that was a mystery that really needed solving, but damn if we didn't just solve it. Let's see. Christina says, oh my God, did you see the last words of Caesar reconstructed in our Discord? I didn't. That sounds really funny, though. Holy shit. How deep does the rabbit hole go? Turns out it goes this deep. It turns out Spider-Man 2, VeggieTales, and that pizza pasta video, and Pizza Tower, I guess, all just reference the same traditional Italian song. So, all right, cool. Thank you all for journeying with me into this exploration of traditional Italian culture. If only Italy were actually real and not just a made-up fantasy of Shigeru Miyamoto when he invented Mario. One day his vision could be brought into the real world. I'm changing my stream category to retro because I think that kind of makes sense. All right, let's get back into it. A controller disconnected. Oh yeah, I guess it would be, right? Because I knocked it off my fucking lap. And this is fucking me up. Because when I hear this song, all I can hear is pizza pasta, put it in a box. Like, I need you guys to know that little, like, pizza pasta, put it in a box, deliver it to my house and put it on my cock. That song, Chandler and I reference it all the time. Like, we will sing it, like, if we're having pizza one night or whatever. Like, it's a whole thing, right? It's a big part of my life. Well, that's maybe a bit of an exaggeration, but you get the idea. All right, cool. Let's start our little timer back up. If I can find my mouse cursor. Here we go. All right, cool. Let's get back into it. All right, so we're still doing the tutorial. We learned how to wall jump. Press X, then hold RT for a quick start with the mock run. Try it out. Oh, cool. Okay. That's actually probably pretty useful because you need some space to wind up the mock run. Yeah. Okay, cool. You can also jump after pressing X in order to do a long jump. Okay, so one thing I'm already seeing is it seems like this game has a lot more movement tech than Wario Land does. Ooh, sorry, what did you have to say? You can also simply run up a slope next to a wall to automatically start wall running. Okay. Yeah, it seems like the freedom of movement in this game is more complicated than it was for Wario Land, which is cool. Is that a Halo 5 Xbox controller? Nope, it is just a normal plain old blue one. While doing a mock run, hold down to destroy blocks in a small gap. Okay. Oh, that's cool. I will say it feels very good to move around in this game. Release down and keep holding RT to continue the mock run. All right, let's see. Can we do that? Okay, cool. Also, I gotta say, I don't know if y'all are seeing this, but these movement animations are, like, insanely dynamic. Ooh. What? If that's so interesting. If I dash into a mock run and then crouch, it does a slide. But if I run into it, he does a roll. Like, the animations in this game are insane. Hold down doing a mock run while in air to do a dive. Okay. Okay, yep, that makes sense. This is all very intuitive, I think. In order to destroy metal blocks, you need to gain speed by doing the mock run. You can hold right to go even faster, too.
Okay.
This background is really good. Yeah, just floating JPEGs of pizza. Yeah, it's pretty solid, I think. Yeah, I don't know. This game looks like... It looks like a Newgrounds animation. Oh, we got another medal? Okay. The whole game looks like it could be an OKKO. There's got to be, like, a word for this aesthetic, right? Because this is something. This is a whole-ass tableau. Running down a slope will make you go faster. But apparently not fast enough. Oh, I see. Okay, I tried rolling. That makes sense. Okay. I can't embarrass myself on the tutorial. To turn while retaining mock run, press the opposite direction. Oh, so can I just, like, keep running back and forth to build up momentum? Okay. So it seems like as long as I have, like, a notional amount of space, right, I can get enough speed. Try turning before falling down a hole. You'll retain your speed once on the ground. What? Okay. Oh, okay, I think I get it. So it's like, yeah, as long as I'm not running headfirst into the wall, I retain my speed. That's kind of cool. OKKO is a good comparison. It's got a sort of that home movie's squiggle vision vibe. Yeah, right? I haven't watched OKKO. I think I watched like one episode because it aired before Steven Universe did. But I think I get the resemblance. While at high speeds, hold up, then release it to perform the super jump. You can also adjust your position with left and right while you are holding up. Okay. Whoa. I'm sorry, am I performing the super jump right now? Hey, I'm sorry, did I just perform the super jump? I think I did. That's kind of a weird mechanic. How much space do I need for that? I guess not much. OKKO rules. I feel like I've heard good things about it. Is it still airing? Because I remember that show being popular a while ago, but I haven't heard much about it since. But then again, I don't have my finger on the pulse of, like, cartoon shows anymore, so I don't know. Another trick. Press X, then down immediately to go through gaps faster. Okay. Or was it like... Oh, I see. So I don't even have to do a mock run to go through gaps. I can just do that. Whoa, he's schmoovin'. Okay, you can slide for a while, huh? Okay. Press grab, then press down. Oh, okay. Yeah. Hi, a little sausage. Oh, I have, like, all these little friends. You can grab things with the grab dash and throw them by pressing X again. Okay. So, yeah, Wario Land had a grabbing mechanic as well. Okay. If you hold up before throwing, you will send things up. Makes sense? Okay. Collect these in order to get a better rank. Some can only be acquired during the escape. Oh, yeah. We should maybe talk about that too, right? So, wait, do I have to, like... What do you mean collect them? How do I collect them? Okay. One of the big mechanics in Wario Land was the escape, right? You need to save most of the dudes in the cages in order to advance to the next floor. They will give you money to pay Mr. Stick. If you miss too many of them, you'll need to replay some levels. Okay. Whoa, that one's got sunglasses. That's very cool. Destroy John the Pillar in order to open the exit gate. This will reverse the solid pillar of blocks. Do you guys... The music just got really serious for a second. This will reverse the solid pillar blocks. I guess they mean these. Okay. Oh! Yeah, okay. Get out! Now! Oh shit, okay. I didn't realize it was so important. There we go. Okay. All right, we're good. Am I timed? Am I, like, deadass actually timed for this? We did it! Okay. And we got zero money for that. Okay, so I guess that really was just the tutorial. Probably could have done that. I probably could have did the tutorial before I did the stream, but whatever. So let's see. This is the... It said it was like the John Hall or something. Let's just see. What else do we have in this here tower? This is the tower lobby. Oh, hi! We got another dude. Okay, topping, secrets, treasure. Cool. What's in here? Here are, I guess, like, our Steam achievements. Alright, cool. I don't really care about achievements right now. That's fine. I aspire to be as cool as Red Action. Who is Red Action?
John Madden.
John Madden. John Madden. Oh, hi. Oh, okay. I guess I can unlock another level if I have money. Yo, is this like some Banjo-Kazooie shit? This is kind of cool. It looks like there are a few levels we have access to. All right, let's just get into a level. You look like a level. You look like a level if I've ever seen one. Pizzascape? Sure. Fucking, yeah, why not? Oh, hi. There's a little TV screen in the top right. So when I was watching the trailers for this, I thought the TV screen represented that this was like a game show, right? I thought maybe this game took place in like a game show. But I guess maybe it takes place in like, maybe the TV is representing that he's being watched or something. I don't know. Okay. Picture the coolest girl ever. That's Red Action. Well, you know what? I'll have to look her up in a second. Okay. I see. So it's like in Wario Land where some enemies you have to like jump on and some of them you're able to grab. Okay, that makes sense. I feel like this game's moveset is so elaborate. I feel like if you got good at it, like you could start to get really fast with this stuff. And I bet it's very satisfying. Do I have health? Oh, shit. Okay. Let's go. Okay. The time has come. It's Wario time. It's Wario time, baby. All right, 10 minutes is up. We are switching from Pizza Tower to Wario Land now. Come on, OBS. OBS, don't do me like this. Don't do me like this. OBS, game capture. Wario Land 4, game capture. Oh, that's right. I changed some settings. How about now? Please? Okay. Give me one sec. I mean, I thought it was going to be Wario time, but apparently not. My emulator says it's actually not Wario time. That I'm a damn fool. That I am a fool and a rube for believing it to be Wario time. All right, once we do this like once or twice, it'll go much smoother, I promise. I accidentally put my emulator into full screen, and I don't know how to unput it in full screen is the problem. Fuck me. This is so cringe. Oh my god. I thought I pushed F11. Hold on. There we go. All right, cool. All right, so now actually detect it, perhaps. Hey, OBS, but actually, like, detect it, please. I swear to God, this was working earlier, and now it is just not. You know what? Okay, fuck it. Let's just make another capture source. It's fine. Fuck it, we'll do it live. And you know what? All right, how about now? Right? Now it should work? Because it literally worked earlier? Ah! It was literally working earlier, though. Hey! All right, taking up the entire screen, but we're here. Obviously not getting any game audio. Obviously not. But that's okay. One thing at a time. I'm gonna use my mouse real quick. The intro to this game is pretty fun too. It's more fun when you have sound effects. Man, why do I even bother setting this shit up ahead of time when it's just not gonna work? That's so cringe. Also kind of fucked up that Wario almost runs over a cat. I feel like that's out of character. I don't feel like he would do that. He's greedy, but he's not a monster. All right, can we get game audio though, please? No, is that actually too much to ask for? No way. Oh, come on. Is it really not going to give me game audio right now? This is so fucked up. Hold on. Literally was working earlier today. This is so fucked up. I'm gonna say it. I'm not playing this game if I can't get game audio working. We'll just play Pizza Tower the rest of the night, I think. Cause like literally, part of what makes Wario Land great is its insane, bonkers, sound design. You had game audio for like 2 seconds, did I? If I did, I did not hear it. Also, yes, my headphones did just die. So that's outstanding timing. Oh, was that something else? Maybe? I don't know what it was you would have heard. Because per my sound sources, you shouldn't be hearing anything right now. But, it's... you know what the most fucked up thing about this is? Is like most of the time, right, when my sound shit doesn't work, it's because I didn't prepare properly, right? And that's fine. That feels fair to me. But I actually did prepare this and it did work and now it just doesn't. All right, let's see. Are we at least getting Pizza Tower sound now? Yeah, all right, cool. Yeah, all right. So we're at least getting sound from this game still. All right, cool, but not Wario though, dude. But dude, not Wario himself. That's so fucked up. Beyond fucked up. All right, I'm gonna try for like 2 more minutes, right? Yeah, and if I can't get audio for this, I'm tapping out. Nothing. We're really getting nothing. It's okay. It was the game for sure. If you heard something, it was probably because here. Okay, look. I'll fucking show you guys. Here's what I can do. Here's what I can do, but it'll fucking suck, right? And I don't like doing this. I could just do audio output capture. I give you all my audio output. Let's see. How's that treating you? Audio output capture. Oh, that's not even giving us anything, actually. That's weird. Oh, sorry. Oh, my God. That probably just blasted the fuck out of your ears, right? I just blasted your audio, right? That sounded good quality if you could turn it down. Yeah. So that's the problem, is now this is our mixed audio. This is just our... That's Pizza Tower that we hear in the background. This is such a shit show. There we go. Okay. So if we do it like this, we can actually get it to work. What you say? You just blasted the hell out of our ears? Not on purpose, okay? Not on purpose. Desktop audio is a reliable source. Right. I mean, that's the thing. God, that was all so fucking cringe. That was also unbelievably cringe. So yeah, like desktop audio, for those of you who do streaming, right? The basic way, you know, the fucking amateur way of capturing your audio is desktop audio. Where basically it'll just broadcast any audio that is running through your computer's sound card, basically. All the windows you have open, everything you have open, it just sends all of it, right? And I don't like that because you're not able to control application volume individually. If you have game and a music and maybe like a YouTube video, you know, if you have multiple tracks, they're all just lumped into the same output, right? I like being able to divide everything up so I can master it all individually, so I could turn off certain things right there from the mixer. You know, you have a lot more control that way. So that's why I like to split out all of my audio sources. The problem is, I don't know if it's just me. I don't know if it's just my ratchet-ass setup or whatever. But for those of you who have been watching long enough, you know it always fails for no discernible reason. So, yeah, like, I don't know. But hey, you know what? Fine, whatever. Sometimes desktop audio comes in clutch, I guess, when application capture is just busted. But we got it now, so. Okay. We did it. I mean, last time I tried to split my audio sources, no one could hear my mic. Uh-oh. I talked for a good hour before anyone clarified that. Oh, no. Going for that mute streamer vibe. Let's see. I'm trying to... You guys let me know if the game audio is at a good volume or not. If it's too loud or too quiet. All right. So I'm actually going to restart. I'm going to restart the emulation so we can watch... We can watch the intro together. Okay? I want to watch the intro together. Reset. There we go. You saw. It's not a very long intro. But... There we go. What I like about this intro is that, like, it's weirdly cinematic for a Game Boy Advance game. So, I watched, like, a 45-minute video about the sound design of this game. And one of the things that's noteworthy about it, that you'll notice as we play it, is its use of vocals, which is not very typical for Game Boy Advance games. Because vocals take a lot of space on cartridges, so they're generally used pretty limitedly. As you might note from the hit game, Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, which only has a few vocals. All right, it looks like we're going to the entry passage. All right, yeah, this is the only place we can go right now, so I guess we'll go here. And this is the only level we can go to. So, okay, cool. We're going to go here. And we're going to start our timer. All right, 10 minutes on the clock, and then we're going to switch back to Pizza Tower. All right, so let's see how far we can get. Let's see. Yeah, game audio seems good. If it's too quiet, let me know. If it's too loud, let me know. Oh my gosh, Ivy Mike. Hello, welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's so good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. Hey Abs, how's the pizza coming along? Can I get a large meat lovers? hey, sure, of course. Oh shit, how do I dash? The controls are different in this game. There we go. Okay, cool. I would be happy to make you a pizza. I actually have a bread machine in my home. So yeah, Chandler and I like to use that to make our very own pizzas. And, yeah, for sure, we can make a meat lovers. Absolutely. Sausage, pepperoni, meatballs. I like to put peppers and onions as well. But you know. You have your own preference. Anyway, thank you so much for subscribing. Your support goes directly back into the channel, as you no doubt know. And yeah, enjoy your Willow emotes. Okay. So already, it's kind of cool. We're already seeing the similarities between this game and Pizza Tower, right? We have the dash, we have the jump, we have the, like, I guess they called it the mock run, right? And we even have in this, there's the gray boulders, right? And then there's the blue ones. And the, well, I guess brown, right? Would you call this gray or brown? I think this is more of a brown. But yeah, it's like how in Pizza Tower we have the marble blocks and the metal blocks. So already, a lot of similarities to the two games. Okay, I guess you just automatically pick stuff up. Sure. A brown like a beige. Okay. All right. I vibe with that. So, okay, I had mentioned that I watched like a 45-minute video about the sound design of this game, and I want you guys to listen for something. One of the things they mentioned in the video blew me away. So listen for this. Thank you. No way! Yeah, okay. So when Wario crouches, the music slows down by like 5%. By like 5 or 10%. The music slows down ever so slightly. Here, I'll do it again. Listen for this. Listen for this. That's so funny. Standing up. And now crouching. Standing. Like, it's so subtle. It's so subtle. That's such a cool detail. So, that's something I think that's kind of special about retro games, is that their music is made in a format called MIDI, right? And in MIDI games, or I guess in MIDI music, essentially what you put on a cartridge is not the music itself, but the instructions on how to play the music. In a modern game, you might just put like an MP3 or, you know, a .wav or whatever on the game, and the game will just stream that audio directly. But that takes a lot of storage space, which, as we mentioned, the Game Boy Advance doesn't have a lot of. So a lot of Game Boy Advance games and a lot of retro games, you know, Super Nintendo, NES and stuff, they would store MIDIs, which, like I said, are just instructions on how to play the music. Basically, the game already has all of the instruments in its storage, and then it just arranges them based on the MIDI's instructions. And that takes up way less space. But the cool thing about that is that means the game is processing... Oh, how do I get that? How do I get the diamond? Can I do this? No, that... Okay. I want the diamond! How do I get it? I don't think I can get it. However I was supposed to get it, I think I fucked it up. Yeah, that's got to be like 5% max. Yeah, right? Like, it's so subtle. But so that's the cool thing about MIDIs, is since they're processed in real time by the game, that means the game can programmically just sort of like... The game can kind of change up the way the music is performed, right? Since it's not already recorded on an MP3 or WAV, a MIDI can just use its programmatic instructions to say, hey, play it slower, or play it at a different pitch, or whatever. And I think that's really cool. Okay, so again, like Pizza Tower, we have this, which in Pizza Tower they called it the escape, right? Where once you reach the end of the level, you have a timer to get out of the level. Fortunately, this level's really easy. This is just the tutorial, so hopefully the next one is a little more difficult. Fun fact, 5% is how much the Blue Sphere special stage music in Sonic 3 and Sonic Mania speeds up every 30 seconds. Okay, I don't know what to do with this information. Your game is always saved when you go back to a passage. Okay, cool, thanks. That's true in real life, too. Let's go. Okay. We have mini games too. I should mention, I had this game as a kid, right? And I remember playing this game as a kid. Do we have... Oh, we have money, so we can actually play these. Let's play a home run derby real quick. I remember liking this one as a kid. Let's give it a try. But we won't get too hung up on... Oh. Right, because you're supposed to hold your Game Boy Advance to its side. Okay. Let's go. Am I nice? Is it just me or am I nice at this? I think I'm nice at this. I'm sorry, Wario Land 4, but this is fucking easy. This is actually, like, kind of, you know... Okay, that one was just a... Okay, don't worry about it. What the... No, okay. Wait, that one I... Okay, all right, we're for real. Okay, no more playing around. Guys, baseball fucking sucks. Like, I don't know if we got any baseball fans in the house here. Never mind, baseball fucking rules, you guys. Y'all, baseball fucking kicks ass, actually. Holy shit, I'm so good. This game is easy. This game's fucking easy as shit. Wario Land 4 is bullshit. This game is fucking bullshit. I can't stand it. What the fuck? Alright. Jokes aside, I don't know how much time I actually want to spend on this. I forget what these frog coins do, right? Oh, what? Wait! You can't do that! Certainly not! But yeah, the way the game works is you get money in the levels, and then you spend that money on mini-games. And then the mini-games you get these frog coins from, but I don't remember what the frog coins do. So, I mean, we probably want at least a couple of them, I think, is probably what we want. Alright, this one... There we go. Frank Drescher. I hope I'm saying that right. Frank Drescher. Wario up to baseball fans. You know what? I bet you if we run the demographics, right? If we run the demographics, we really crunch the numbers, I bet there is some considerable overlap between Wario fans and baseball fans. And I don't know what I'm basing that off of, but it just feels right to me. It feels right. Oh, oh, do we get like a little halftime? Okay. Cool. What are we at? 9? We got 9. Okay. Hey y'all. It is scaring me that what the fuck? If you look in the top left corner there where it shows how many home runs I've got, or I guess in the No. Okay, sorry. I got to focus up. Bullshit. This game blows. All right, that's enough. That's enough of this. It was worrying me that this goes into the triple digits. Oh, is that 10 minutes? All right, we're at 10 minutes already. Let's go, baby. Back to Pizza Tower. Hell yeah, bro. Let's go. Oh, wait, hold on. I gotta do one thing super quick. All right, cool. All right, let's go. Oh, yeah, I gotta put 10 more minutes on the clock. All right, 10 minutes on the clock. We got 10 minutes of Pete's Tower, and once that is up, we are going back to Wario Land 4, baby. All right, let's go. I don't mean to keep backing out of this. Is it just me, or is the game too loud? This game feels a little too loud. We'll bump it down a few decis. Probably good. All right. Let's see. Allison, hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. So good to see you. Vale says, I'm sure there's a baseball micro game on one of the WarioWares. Oh, there's absolutely. Absolutely there is. Oh, the WarioWare games are so good. Also, Blaze says, that sounds right for some reason. It's because I never miss. I never miss. I'm always right. I'm still kind of wrapping my head around the sort of grabbing and throwing mechanic. Like, this is the kind of game where it feels like I should be way more fluid at this than I am. Right? Also, do I have health? Like, I'm taking hits and stuff, but, like, do I have to worry about dying? I do not see a health bar. I guess maybe getting hit just slows me down. I'm not sure. When they said hit or miss, you know what they said next about Abby. Yeah. Hit or miss? I guess I never miss, huh? I bet a speedrun of this game looks fucking insane. Excuse me? pardon? I have a double jump and a sword? Okay, this is so interesting. So now that I'm wearing armor, I can actually, yeah. I can't change my trajectory mid-air, right? If that makes sense, it's kind of hard to explain verbally, but when I jump, I'm already set on my arc. I can't change mid-air anymore. Also, my jumps feel a lot heavier, and... Okay, I also can't dash, and I also can't exit a slide. Yeah. Oh, okay. I guess I have a C now. This is Ghouls and Ghosts as fuck. I know, okay, and I got knocked out of it. This is Ghouls and Ghosts as fuck. Or Ghouls and... Ghosts and Ghouls? Ghouls and Goblins? What's the name of that game? This is like that game. An interesting touch with the sound and jump effects to make the armor look and feel heavy. Yeah, right? Like, for sure, I was definitely feeling that. Believe me, from gameplay, it felt fucking heavy, too. All right, I think I'm doing really good, actually. I'm supposed to be finding the little, like, pizza characters, right? Like, the little pizza toppings. Okay, let's try this again. What is up with these little guys? I guess I lost it already. Hi. Hi, what's your deal? It's just like a big fucking hamster. What's your deal, my guy? Maybe I need to slay the hamster with my armor. Maybe I have to use my... Oh! Okay, this fucking guy breaks my armor, I think. They were like, what if Ratatouille was bigger? Yo, okay. Yeah, okay. We love it. What if Ratatouille was, like, huge and yoked and jacked and shit, right? But also, giant Ratatouille controlled a giant person as well. Is that anything? Big Ratatouille controls a hill giant. Is that anything? Raccoony? Like a raccoon? Yeah. Okay, Ratatouille, but he's a raccoon and he's controlling, like, a hill giant. Is that anything? Is this anything? I also, Allison, love the suggestion. Do not think we could call the character Raccoony. That doesn't pass the sniff test for me. And maybe that's just my problem, but... Alright, so it looks like these little guys... Oh, whoa. Okay, so when I'm in armor, I can't even go up a slope. Okay. Like, you automatically just slide down slopes. Catatoy. Catatoy is something. That I love. Okay, we got a key. Hey, Abs. How's your day been going? Just joined. Oh my gosh, Will. Hello. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's so good to see you. I hope you're doing really well. I don't know about y'all. I'm doing great tonight. I am doing fantastic. I was talking about this earlier in stream. I've been feeling great lately. I've been having good vibes. I've been drinking a lot of water. I've been sleeping a lot, right? I'm doing great. And I've been really excited, actually, specifically to play Pizza Tower. Because I've been listening to this game's soundtrack nonstop for, like, the last month, right? And I've wanted to play it on stream. So, yeah, now that I finally have this chance, I'm really happy because it's a fun game so far. Okay, I'll humor this question. Where do you tuck the good when you sit like that? Exactly where you think I would. Away. Yeah. Yeah, Christina says it. Yeah, away. Don't worry about it. The details? Don't worry about it. It goes somewhere else. Don't be weird, Jack. Don't be weird, is all I'm gonna say. Also, how the fuck do I get out of here, please? Did the game just troll me? I don't know how to get out of here. Can I do, like, a super jump? Is this like that bit in Fallout 4 where you wear the power armor and there's, like, do you guys know this part? There's a part in Fallout 4 where there's, like, a really deep well, and if you walk into it with power armor, you very quickly learn that you cannot swim in power armor. And when I, at that part, I had to fucking ditch my power armor at the bottom of a well. Hey, what do I do? There, hey guys, there's literally a note on the wall that says, "Double jump, my liege." There you go. Literally, they put that there. They put that notice there for me, because I forgot to fucking double jump. Can you do like a hold down and press jump to go below the platform? Right, like I was trying that. Abby, I have a lap cat. Oh my god. Oh my god, Allison, I am so jealous. I do not have a lap cat. Willow, okay. I've started getting into the habit of reading at night, right? I've been reading Snow Crash. I think I've talked about that. And Willow has started to catch on to my habit, and she likes to lay down next to me at night while I'm reading. It's really nice. I think it's actually one of my biggest incentives to keep reading is that when I read, Willow hangs out with me, and she likes it, and it makes her happy. I have two cats in my room. It's very blessed. Oh my god. Holy shit. Please, to any of you, if you have a cat in your presence right now, tell me, did I just fucking obliterate that guy? Okay. Tell me, I want to hear about your cats. Like, just know that at any given moment, I probably want to hear about your cat. I want to go up here. I guess I don't have to go up here, actually. I guess we could just go this way, right? So this game is interesting too, and this is true for Wario Land, but when you're done with the level, you have to complete the level in reverse. So it's like I'm kind of trying to make like a mental note of the layout of this level, because once we reach the end, we're gonna have to go through it again, but in the opposite direction, you know? And I feel like that's a lot for my sort of dumb idiot brain to handle, but that's okay. I mainly started reading seriously to impress a cat also. Oh my gosh, Frank, that's so funny. That's so fucking funny. I love, hi. You're following me. Okay, I guess that's fine. I love the way you put that, Frank. You started reading to impress a cat. And like, yeah, that's exactly what it is, right? That's exactly what it is. I'm trying to impress my cat. I'm trying to impress Willow. I love that. Like, I'm gonna become a super, like, well-read erudite just to impress my cat. I swear to God. That's so fucking funny. We probably have to go the other way, right? My cat looking out the window like every- Oh! Oh shit, we activated pizza time. Okay, did not realize we were gonna trigger pizza time. That's fine. Okay, we have plenty of time. We can get out of here. Oh shit, we have 2.5 minutes. Okay, yeah. This is fine. I don't know how to get past this guy. There we go. Alright, thank you. Okay, our Wario Land timer is up, but we are just gonna finish this level first. I literally feel anxious right now. Can I break through these? Oh no, we wall run. That's right, okay. Okay, yeah. Okay, I remember this part. Nice. Okay. I think we wanna go this way. Yeah, all right, that works. So as a general rule, I gotta say, I am a sucker for, and this is so specific, you guys, I'm a sucker for escape sequences in video games, right? I'm talking like in Metroid, right? In Super Metroid at the beginning where you have to escape from, what is it, like Brimstar or whatever the fuck at the beginning. Love that shit. I love this shit that's going on right now. What are other good escape? Oh, did I win? Oh, no. We're so close. We're so close. Let's go. Hey, okay. All right, let's go. Don't mind if I do. So we got $50. I've done worse for $50. Very nice. Very nice. Know where that y'all better get funky audio is from? Oh god. Oh my gosh. Blaze, you know that exact sample? What the fuck? All right, let's check out your sample, and then we'll switch over to Wario Land. Goodbye, 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 goodbye. All right. So, okay, actually, I wanted to talk about this too, right? Is this game continues a trend from Wario Land 4. Wario Land 4 used a lot of audio samples from, like, MIDI libraries, right? So in making MIDI music, it's very common for... Ooh, that is the wrong scene. We want to do this one. Okay. All right, let's see. Blaze called shot, knows exactly where the y'all better get funky is from. The right time? This sounds nice. I'm like on the edge of my yoga ball right now. I'm on the fucking edge of my seat. I don't know if that's it. Hold on. We gotta do like a 1-to-1. Yes, it's the same phrase. I'm sorry, Blaze. Amazing called shot. I don't think it's the sample. Detective. Yeah, we're doing some real detective ass work right now. I don't recall how long into the song they say y'all ready to get funky. Investigation start. Yeah, okay. Let's listen very carefully. Okay. Oh shit, it's so close. No, you're right. It's the same one. Absolutely. Dead to rights. It's the same sample. Absolutely. I'm sorry. Maybe I'm just like bad at identifying voices or whatever. Tell me it's not. Tell me it is not the same. Y'all ready to get funky. Here, I'll give us one mo. Just one mo. Yeah, I think it is. I think it is, absolutely. I think it absolutely is. Holy shit. Blaze, good fucking call. Good fucking call with that. All right, great. let's get into Wario time. Let's get back into Wario time. Oh, please don't do me like this. Don't do me like this, Wario, though. Hey, Wario, don't do me like this, though. It does not want to detect. Let's see, we're at least getting... There we go. All right, cool. We're good. I was being dramatic for nothing. We are really crushing it today, I think. As a group, as a collective, I think we're doing a lot of good work today. All right, cool. 10 minutes on the clock. And it's Wario time, baby. All right, so we were looking at minigames. I just want to see real quick, is there anything I could spend these medals on? I don't see anything, so we're just going to keep going. Spoiled Rotten? Sure. Why not? But yeah. Okay, so one thing I wanted to talk about was that... Right. So Wario Land used MIDI sound effects, MIDI sound libraries in its music. Hi. Look at this Game & Watch looking motherfucker. That's an Apple Bomb. Okay. What does it do? Okay. I don't know if I wanted to buy that, my guy. I don't know what that does. Oh! That's kind of cool. It starts the boss off with less health. Okay. All right, this is the first boss. It can't be that hard, right? It's like a baby. I don't want to beat up on it. Oh, God. Oh, God. This is grisly. Mario could never. There we go. Let's go. Mario could never. Is that an eggplant? It sure looked like it. It looked like a fat eggplant. Okay. Let's go. I love your Wario emotes, by the way. That's so cute. That's so funny.
This is like taking candy from a baby, which is fine by me.
Holy shit. Okay. All right. So now we've got some options. Sapphire, Topaz. Who else? Someone gifted me a sub in that channel, so they are all coming in clutch. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. What's the channel? Is it a very Wario-centric channel? You could buzz mark it. I don't mind. Who's this little scamp? Who's this lovable little scamp over here? I want to say hi to him. Let's check out the sound room. Hi, we have jack shit. All right, cool. I guess let's go... I don't know, what's your vibe? Topaz, ruby, sapphire, or emerald? I'll scope out sapphire for now, but let me know if you have a preference. Crescent Moon Village. Okay. Toy Block Tower. Okay. So we really do. We have freedom to pit the Curious Factory. Okay. Sapphire. Oh, shit. Too late. We're doing Ruby. Fuck. I didn't mean to do this. What it is... Here, I have an excuse. I always have an excuse. My A and B buttons are swapped because on the Game Boy Advance, A is here and B is here. So in my... Fredophobic bit? Sorry, wait. I don't know what that means. Am I being dunked on right now? Do I need to ban this person? What does Fredophobic mean? Skank booby streamer, stop invalidating a talent. Wait, hold on. Don't like ban or block them. I can't tell if you're being cringe or if you're being funny right now. I literally couldn't tell if that person was being cringe or funny. No, they're na- okay. But yeah, so I've set my emulator so A and B are swapped, right? So I was trying to back out of the menu, so I pushed B, which is A. And then I ended up entering the level. So, yeah, whatever. We're in this level now. This is the level we're in now. Which is fine. You know what? As a general rule, I do... Oh, shit. I do like a good, I do like a good factory level, as a general rule. But, Oh, but yeah, so we were talking about, MIDI sound effects, right? Is that, you know, back in the day, and probably to this day, right? Okay, I guess we can. Alright. When making MIDI music, it is common to take samples from MIDI libraries, right? So if you have a good ear, you can actually notice similar sound effects used in video games, used in music, used in TV shows, because they all take from the same sound library. So that's what we experience in the clip, Y'all Ready to Get Funky, right? I think what happened there was it was just two different sounds taking from the same library. So Blaze, the song that you posted may not have even been the progenitor of that soundbite. It is possible that whoever made that sound actually took it from like a sound library. And then it's possible that whoever made Pizza Tower, they took the sound from the same sound library, which is pretty cool. Is this? Yeah, okay, it is a secret block. What? Hi. Oh, sorry. Progenitor? Originator, right? That means originator. I think I needed to throw that little guy. He's cute. I don't think I could throw him now, though. Can I restart? Important update. Iggy has moved under the desk for a change. That is- God damn it. I just decked him again. Iggy has moved under the desk for a change of scenery. That is an important update. Is there perhaps a computer under your desk? If so, Iggy might be looking to take some of the good warmth of your computer. I know Willow likes to do that sometimes. I guess I could probably roll? Yeah, there we go. Yeah, good update for sure. I pride myself on knowing words others don't, but even I ain't never heard of no progenitor, lol. yeah, so progenitor just means originator, the originator of something. Can you demonstrate the providence of this MIDI track, please? I don't think I can, but I can try. I can try. Here, hold on. Let's see. Let's see if we can make something happen here. I'm just gonna throw a little search into YouTube here and see what we get. All right, I'm just gonna search for Y'all Ready to Get Funky. Wow. Wow, looking up Y'all Ready to Get Funky actually just brings up Pizza Tower shit. What is this? What the fuck? I feel like I shouldn't be watching this, actually. I feel like I shouldn't be watching whatever that is. Oh, shit. Do they use it in Jet Set Radio, too? What about this? All right, answer. I cannot find. I cannot demonstrate the providence of this MIDI track. All right. I'll try one more Google search. I'll try one more. Y'all Ready to Get Funky MIDI. Y'all ready for this? Y'all ready to get... Oh. By the Jastronauts. Oh, here we go. Complete Funk MIDI Bundle. This might be it. Holy shit. Wait. Can we sample it, please? Oh, it's gotta be in here somewhere. So in music production, this is a very common thing, right? Is you can buy bundles of MIDI sound effects, right? So what this track is basically demonstrating that this bundle has like these instruments, right? So like the pipe organ, the string instrument you hear, the piano you hear, the little little drum kit, right? All of that is in this bundle. This is a sample of a song you can make with this bundle. And it's not uncommon for different artists to buy the same bundles and then you hear the same samples or instruments in their bundle. So maybe the complete funk MIDI bundle has a sample of someone saying, "Y'all ready to get funky?" And then Pizza Tower and that other song use the same sample. I don't know. It might come from Eye to Eye, considering they also use the guy saying other things. So, okay, here's the thing. You might be right, Blaze. Or whatever bundle they bought included that guy saying several lines. You get what I'm saying, right? It's possible that the bundle included the guy saying, "Y'all get ready to get funky," and also saying other things. And then they arrange that into a song. That's also not uncommon in music production. But I don't know. I don't know. Unless I could find the exact bundle "Y'all Ready to Get Funky" comes from. Unless I could track it down, I can't say for sure. I was asking that as a bit of a riff and didn't expect you to actually look this up. Oh, Frank, you're new around here. This is what we do on this channel. We don't play video games. We turn video games on sometimes, and then I get distracted and do other stuff. I don't know. The song is from 1999. Seems like it could have been made then. I agree. And then I don't know if Pizza Tower can then steal that sample. You know what I mean? Like, surely they did not get the buy-off from Eye to Eye to use that sound. For sure they did not. So, like, I don't know. I'm gonna scrub through this track just a little bit and then we'll go back to Wario Land. The problem is, in this little sample kit, I'm not hearing any vocal tracks. Yeah. Which is really sort of putting a damper on my theory here. You know, guys, I think I know the solution. I have to spend $15 to buy the complete funk MIDI bundle. I thought samples under a certain length were fair use. You might be right. I am not an expert on fair use. Cause on my streams, I just steal copywritten stuff and use it all the time. Just think, this sample pack is too modern. You gotta search. Oh shit, you're right. You're so right. When did this release? When did the sample pack release? Does it say? Blaze, that's so insightful. Yeah. When did this release? Because, yeah, if this sample pack came out after 1993, then there's no shot. Then there's no way. Let's see. Y'all ready to get funky on Beatport? Y'all ready to get funky sample? Let's see. What is Beatport? See, this is 2016. There's no way. Nah, this isn't it. This isn't our sample. This isn't our beautiful "Y'all Ready to Get Funky." What about you? Nah, this isn't it either. Unless maybe they use the same... Nah. Okay, this is nothing. Beatcore is music to beat the shit out of people too. That's just music. That's just what I consider music in general. This is pretty funky though. You know what it probably is? Blaze, you know what it probably is? It's probably like a fucking CD. Right? I bet you the sample is on some sort of, like, fucking CD that you would have to buy at, like, an old, like, music store or something. Right? Like, I don't think I'm gonna find this online. Alright. I gotta pull the ripcord. We gotta exit this bit, because I can get lost in here forever. I think I can sincerely get lost in this forever. Alright, we were in what? Wario Land, right? I think we have like 2 minutes left. Yeah, okay, cool. We got like 2 minutes. Alright, let's see how much I could do in 2.5 minutes. Let's see if I can make some magic happen. So, okay, this is something about this level, right? Is getting smushed by these things doesn't damage me. It makes me flat. And when I'm flat, I'm wider, so I could probably cross that gap I wasn't able to cross before. And it also gives me this little, like, glide? I think that's so interesting that, like, I guess there's limited transformation abilities in this game. I get, you know, it's kind of like, okay, it's kind of like the armor suit from Pizza Tower, right? It changes the way the character behaves. That's really cool. Is this anything? No. Okay. Okay. I'll say it, right? This little mechanic here, where you, like, step on these platforms to move the platform, right? I think it's kind of tedious. Like, I've seen this in different platformers from this era, right? Like, I'm pretty sure, like, Donkey Kong Country had a similar mechanic, right? I think it's kind of tedious, and I don't think it really adds much. I love the goofs in Wario games. The sense of humor, I think you really only see it in the Mario and Luigi RPGs otherwise. Yeah, right? Like, that... Oh, wow. Okay, I didn't even come close to solving this puzzle. Do diamonds do anything? Do diamonds do anything in this game? Because I don't think they do. Oh, shit. I reset my timer. I reset it to 10 minutes on accident. All right, we'll switch. We'll switch once the timer reaches 7. Right. They sparkle. That's so true. And you know what, I guess, you know what, hey, the same could be said about diamonds in real life, right? Do they do anything? Well, they make you feel good if you get one, and they sparkle, and that's pretty nice. That's true, I get, oh shit. Am I gonna fucking die? There we go, all right, we're good. I find it so interesting that, like, stuff like getting set on fire and getting, like, smushed to a pancake doesn't actually damage you in this game. That feels so weird to me. I think there might be a treasure completion rate in this game, too. Ah, fuck. Well, I don't know. I don't know about diamonds. I think diamonds might just be money. Also, either way, I'm not going for 100%. It's fine. You know? I know I was, like, really bigging up this game's sound design, right? But I feel like the track in this level kind of sucks. Like, I feel like this song kind of sucks. And, like, you know, as a general rule, I quite enjoy the soundtrack on factory levels. As a general rule, I think factory levels tend to have a better soundtrack. Oh! We found it! Wait, oh shit! Oh shit, alert, okay, alert, breaking news. Blaze found it. Blaze found y'all ready to get funky. This is so huge. Okay, drop that link. Drop that beautiful link. I'm on the edge of my seat. Y'all ready to get funky is from 1991, okay? Oh shit. This might be the biggest thing that's ever happened on this stream. By the way, we're done with Wario Land 4 right now. When we're done checking this out, we'll switch over to Pizza Tower. Oh shit. That's older than me. Yeah, 91, that's older than me as well. Okay, okay, okay. Blaze, you are doing the fucking Lord's work right now. Let's see. Who sampled? Oh, okay. Okay. So wait, what is this? Where are we? Oh, you posted the video. Okay, cool. Okay. Okay, this is the video. Got it. And this is the one you said 2 minutes 15 seconds in. Okay. Loletta Holloway. Okay. Put some fucking respect on Holloway's name. Holy shit. Holy shit. There it is. Completely unmodulated. The soundtrack is on Bandcamp too through the composer. Okay. I've been listening to the soundtrack on YouTube, and yeah, it's outstanding. It's very good. It's like $10 on Steam too. I might buy it. Okay, so this is it. We found it. Honestly, I am clearly, I am ready to get funky, as we have demonstrated. All right, so we have solved it. Congrats, please. We have found that the same. You know what? Actually, hey guys, we've been doing a lot of musical work today, right? We found out that the pizza song from Spider-Man 2 for PlayStation 2 shares a sample with VeggieTales, with Pizza Tower, with that Pizza Pasta Put It in a Box video, and that it all originates from a traditional Italian song. And then we found out Are You All Ready to Get Funky comes from this song in 1991. So yeah, yep. Godspeed, we've been doing great work today. We've been doing outstanding work today. All right, cool. Look, what are we at? We're at 2.5 hours. Oh God, it's almost 9:30. Fuck. Here, how about this? We'll do 10 more minutes with Pizza Tower, right? And then we will finish up our level in Wario Land, and then we'll wrap up. I think that seems like a good strat for us tonight. All right, cool. This has been a very eventful night for us, I think. Very musical night. I love that. I'm a big fan of video game music, as you all know. All right, let's get 10 minutes on the clock, please. Thank you. All right, and let's see. I think we just cleared a level, didn't we? Yeah, we did. And we cleared it with an A. So, yeah, take that. Now, it looks like this level we could unlock for $100. We do not have $100, so I guess we could do this level? Let's try this one. All right, Okay. Yeah, there he, look at me. Look at me learning the moveset of this video game. Yeah, I think the move is to just mock run everywhere and then just beat the shit out of everyone. You know what? I don't have a health bar, I don't think. I don't think Pepino can die. I think he's literally just running off of the raw feral energy of a of an Italian that's in debt. There we go. I have found a secret. Okay. Did I win? I feel kind of violated, actually. Like, I don't know what just happened, but it didn't feel great. You can die if you get Pizza Man. I don't know what that means, and I'm afraid to find out. Oh, I love these little, like, goblins. Oh, they throw bombs that you could pick up. Okay. Got it, that I could use to destroy giant Ratatouille. If the timer runs out. Okay. But the timer only shows up at the end of the game, at the end of the level, right? So until I get to the escape, right, until the timer starts, I'm good, it seems like? Ow. Wait, Allison, have you played this game before? Are you familiar? Are you a real Pizza Tower head? Are you a real Pizza Tower buff? I didn't realize that. That's great. It's insane to me, by the way, right? It's insane to me, by the way, that they have that little TV, right, in the upper right corner. Because literally all that means is they had to draw, like, way more animation for this game for, like, no reason. Like, these motherfuckers literally chose to draw more animation. No wonder this game took, like, 5 years or some shit to make. We got a pizza gamer over here. No, I saw a clip of someone playing it. Got it. Okay. Yeah, Allison is a real pro pizza gamer. I feel like not a lot of people know that about her, but yeah. Sir, please. Sir, there we go. Thank you. I'm not sure where to go. Because I already went this way, I'm pretty sure. I probably missed something around here. Because this goes back to the entrance? Yeah, okay. So maybe it has something to do with this little, like, platform? No? No, I guess maybe I did do everything here. Alright, let's try this way. Oh, that's right, I have the key now. Okay, cool. Yeah, good work. Nice. You got a key. See, I knew Allison was a real pro pizza gamer. She knew that I got the key before even I did. Okay, so I just noticed something. Earlier, when I got hit, it lowered my rank from a C to a D. Yeah, see, it just happened again. So that, I think that's how this works. Yeah. So you don't have health, and you can't die, right? But when you get hit, you lose points. I think that's how... Actually, let's see. I have 2-1... Yeah, okay. Also, a screen appeared saying, you hurt Peppino 10 times. Which I don't think does anything, but it did make me feel very bad. So I guess it was effective in that regard. So, okay, this seems really cool. I guess you can't die from taking damage, but whenever you take damage, you loot your score drops. I think that's a cool way of handling this. So I still don't want to get hit, because I want to get a good rank. But I'm not going to fucking die and fail the level. That's cool. I like that. So, like, if you just want to beat the fucking game, you don't have to worry about, like, not getting hit and stuff. That's cool. That's really good game design. I didn't remember where the key went, but you had it. Yeah. No, that's good. See, that's one of the things I like about streaming, is that it's like, if I forget shit, I could just, I can count on you to remember stuff for me, because you guys are much smarter than I am. All right, Ratatouille, come here. Uh-oh, fuck. I have a B right now, actually. I want to keep my B rank. There we go. All right, cool. I don't know how to move this guy. Give me a bomb. Oh, fuck. You know, I don't need that secret zone that badly. It's fine. Okay, I see. Those, I can only remove those in one direction. That makes sense. No way. I was like 2 inches away. That's fine. Yeah, all right, cool. Wait, I want the big sausage. Wait. All right, I don't know. I guess I don't care that much, actually. Oh, just kidding. I do care. Let's go. Haha, let's go. All right, so it looks like our timer is almost up. And here's what I'm going to say. We're going to finish this level, and then we're going to finish the WarioWare level. Not WarioWare, Wario Land level. And then we'll call it a day. I think that makes for a pretty good, pretty solid stream. The animation of holding the bomb. Oh, I don't know. I didn't catch that. Next time I have a bomb, I'll take a look. Do you mean the TV screen animation in the top right corner? I'll take a look at that. I guess if we encounter any more bombs, though, right? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, the animation of Peppino just, like, panickedly holding a bomb. I love it. Oh, what is the point of this? All right, whatever. It's so weird. I really like the TV animations. I think the TV animations are really endearing, and, like, they have a lot of character. But, like, there's part of me that's like, why did you make those? Like, why did you make those? They add nothing to the game, like, substantially, I don't think. Okay. All right, is there like a world map I can open up or something, or no? All right, we really do just have to go for this, huh? Okay. All right. Well, have at thee. Wait, what? Okay. I guess we're in a secret zone now. Am I able to just leave the secret zone if I don't want to be here anymore? I feel like I can do this. Yeah, okay, there we go. Oh shit, yeah, we're still on the clock. Okay, yeah, the fucking pizza man is waking up right now. Oh shit, oh fuck. You can't expect me to do precise platforming under circumstances like this. Yeah, I'm feeling it. I'm letting the Italian energy flow through me. Oh shit. No. I'm trying. Okay. This is fine. If we climb up, I think... Nope. Oh, no. Okay, if I super jump, that's right. Yeah, there we go. Now we're playing video games. Oh shit. Okay. Oh, this is fine. We're fine. Shit, we only have like 30 seconds left. It's fine. No. This game's hard. I thought I was gonna end on a high note. All right. So we didn't look. We whiffed it on this level. But we still got one other, right?
Let's see.
Maybe we can clutch it in Wario Land. Oh yeah, hold on. Yeah, oofs in the chat, please. I should have done better. You deserve better from me. You deserve better from me. I'm telling you. All right. And pause. Well, good. Fuck. Hey, good news. I accidentally reset my emulator. Ah, this is so bad. This is so bad. Well, I guess we just call it here then, right? I guess we just call it here. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. All right. Well, it's fine. It's fine. Hey, I had fun today. What are we at? We're at like, yeah, we're going on like 3 hours. I think this is maybe a good time to wrap it up. I think this is maybe a good time to wrap it up. Hey, we'll just listen to this for a little bit, I think. Had lots of fun. Aw, thank you. Thank you. I had a lot of fun too. I think I'm definitely gonna play more Pizza Tower. That might become my new Steam Deck game, right? That might just be the game that I play on my Steam Deck, like when I'm hanging out or whatever. Probably won't play it on stream again. We did. We learned a lot today, actually. We learned way more today than I was expecting to learn. Yeah, we learned about MIDI samples. Learned about all kinds of stuff. Let's pop back in just chatting. I'm thinking as we wrap up here, what music do we want to listen to? Do we want to listen to Pizza Tower or do we want to listen to Wario Land? Let's listen to Pizza Tower, because I already have a playlist for that one. Yeah, this is a cool vibe. All right, so let's see as we wrap up for our evening. Do I have anything that I want to talk about? Let me think. Do I have anything I want to talk about? Any announcements? As you guys know, there's a new episode of the Court Wreckers podcast. That's one thing I mentioned at the top of the stream. Court Wreckers is my Ace Attorney podcast that I co-host with Mish. And we dropped a new episode this week, and I'm really happy with it, and I think it turned out really well. I am trying to get on a better schedule with that podcast. I want to upload at least once a month, and ideally I want to get on a bi-weekly uploading schedule. Historically, I've been not so great at editing it, which has taken me a while. But once I have a good workflow for Court Wreckers established, I'll give you guys a little bit of insider info. Thinking about maybe starting another project. So I won't say anything more about it now, because I don't know if it'll become a thing. But yeah, so that might happen. What else do I want to talk about? No stream on Saturday, I don't think. Let me check my fucking schedule. Oh, okay. Yeah. So that's what I wanted to talk about. Okay. Yeah. That was what I wanted to talk about. So yeah, we're not going to be doing a stream on Saturday, but next Thursday, I am giving your pets RPG stats, right? So if you have not already, head on over to our Discord. We have a channel called, what did I call the channel? It's called like Pet Review or something. Animal Stats. We have a channel called Animal Stats. Go check out the Animal Stats channel and go ahead and post a photo of your pet, please. I want to see them. And then next stream on Thursday the 23rd, I will be giving all of your pets RPG stats. So I'm really looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. So for sure, submit your photos. Yeah, you have a week. Yeah, you're good, Blaze. But please submit something. I want to see it. So yeah, there's that. What else? I think that's pretty much all. Allie is ready. Allie, I think you were like the first one to submit a photo to it, actually. I think you're actually like the first one. Yeah, do I have anything else I want to talk about? I don't think so. Yeah, I think I'm pretty much good. Yeah, I guess that's it. Sorry, I'm looking at my OBS preview and I'm realizing I might have been fucking upskirting the camera like this entire time. I'll check the VOD later and determine how embarrassed I need to be, but whatever, it's fine. I'm always hyped for sharing cat photos. Yes. Oh my gosh, that is one of my favorite things about the Discord is seeing cat photos. I don't always respond because I don't really have much to say about cat photos, but I always love seeing them. It's one of my favorite things about being a cat owner. But yeah, I think we're done. I think we're done here. Let's find someone to raid. There's actually a lot of people online right now. But I think I know who we'll go with. We'll go with an old classic because she usually streams around the same time as me. You guys know her. You love her. She is... Oh, whoops. Oh, Mish, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. You don't have to give me bits, but you do anyway. Everything you give goes back into supporting the channel. You know this. I almost... Guys, this is so fucking cringe. I almost typed slash raid another Inu fan into her chat. Like, that's so fucking funny, actually. She's playing Disco Elysium. So you guys know another Inu fan. You know Maya. She is dear friend of the channel. She, through a bizarre chain of circumstances, is responsible. Actually, hey, we could talk about this. This is kind of funny. Maya is the reason I am into Homestuck. Right? And me being into Homestuck is why I met my college friends. So, Allison, in chat right now, you and I would not be friends if it was not for another Inu fan, if it wasn't for Maya. Now, butterfly effect being what it is, you could probably say that about a lot of stuff, but I just think it's pretty... That is you. Yes, that is you. Yeah. But, yeah, she's playing Disco Elysium right now. Maya is an artist. She did my profile picture. She is very sweet. She does very nice streams, so. So, yeah, go check it out. And, yep, Twitch is kicking me out. I will catch you guys next Thursday. I hope you have a very great week. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Take care.